Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through one marker questions related to probability topic. So here's the list of questions for probability. The first one is the probability of getting a multiple of 3 when a die is thrown. A die has 6 numbers, is it not? Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you need to get a multiple of 3. That means you can get 3 and 6. Right? You can get 3 and 6. These are the two numbers you can get in the die. And what is the count? What is the number of outcomes or number of possibilities? 2, right? 2 possibilities, 3 and 6, 2 possibilities. And what is the total outcome? You can get number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, any of those numbers from 1 to 6 you can get, right? From 1 to 6, any of the numbers you can get. So total possibilities is 6. Now what is the formula of a probability? Favorable outcomes by total outcomes. Favorable is the outcomes that is desired, which is 2 here. 2 and total outcomes is 6. 2 by 6 is 1 by 3. Second one, a card is drawn from a pack of 52 cards. What is the probability that it is a queen card? Now, the total outcome is 52. When you take out a card from 52 cards, it can be any of that, right? So the possibilities are 52. You have 52 possibilities. So total possibility is 52, right? Now, what is the desired outcome? You need to get the queen card. How many queens are there in 52 cards? There are 4 queens. How many? There are 4 queens. Right? So it is 4 possibilities. 4 possibilities. So what is probability? Desired possibilities by total possibilities. So 4 by 52, which is 1 by 13. So next one. An unbiased die is rolled. Find the probability of getting a face with multiple of 2 dots. Basically, right, in the die, you should be getting 2 dots, multiple of it. So you can have 4, you can have 6. So how many combinations? You can have 2, 4, 6. Right? You can have die with 2, then you can have 4 wins. And then you can have 6, right? So 3 combinations. So total outcomes is 6. So it's 3 by 6, which is half. Now, next one. If probability of A is 3 by 4 and probability of B is half, and if probability of A and B is 1/4, then find the value of probability of A given B. So you'll have to remember the formula. What is probability of A given B? It's nothing but probability of A and B by probability of B. Here, remember to put the denominator same. So you have B here, right? A by B. So in the denominator, you should have probability of B. So this is one clue. So whatever is there in the denominator should be the same. And the numerator will always have probability of A and B. That is both occurring together. Both A and B occurring together. So here it's already given. A and B is 1/4. Probability of B is given, right? This probability of A is not required. It is sometimes given just to confuse, right? Now, if there was a question, twisted question, instead of giving this, right, instead of giving this, if they give you this, like this, that is A or B, instead of A and B, if they give you A union B or A or B, then you'll have to use one more formula. You'll have to use another formula, right? So you'll have to use this formula. A or B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B, right? Now, this is given. This is given, this is given. You have to find this. Why you have to find this? So that you can use it in this particular formula. Here, you'll have to find probability of A given its complement. The complement is given, right? This denotes complement. Complement is given, you have to find probability of A. Simple. So, it's always 1 minus probability of A is probability of its complement, right? The complementary, the probability of complementary event is 1 minus probability of the event. So, remember this formula. So, 1 minus 0.65 will be the answer. That is 0.35. Next one, for 2 mutually exclusive events, A and B, probability of A is given, probability of B is given. Find probability of A or B. A or B. So you should remember the formula. One thing, mutually exclusive events. You'll have to remember what is mutually exclusive, what are independent, right? Mutually exclusive event is either A can happen or B can happen. Both can't happen together. Either this or either that. For example, when a die is thrown, you should get even numbers and you should get odd numbers. Can both happen? When I throw a die, can I get an even number and odd number? No, right? It's not possible. It's either one of them. That is an example of mutually exclusive events. So in mutually exclusive events, first of all, this one is null. That is A and B. Possibility of both the events happening is empty, null, zero, right? So this is the main formula for probability, right? A or B is probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. But this is empty for mutually exclusive events. So you substitute probability of A, probability of B, and find this probability of A or B. So with this, we've come to the end of this particular topic. If you've liked this video, do press a like and share it. Thank you.